Hello and welcome back to Star Trek New Worlds. When we last left off, we entered an uneasy alliance with the Loyalist Talbot faction on the volcanic planet of Ixion, another Von very rich in dilithium, which is of course very important for the Klingon Empire. And in doing so, we eliminated the rival or rebellious Talbot faction and by extension also their base. As it turns out, they had some outside help all along in the form of the Orion privates or crime syndicate or whatever, but to be honest, they're just a loose formation of privateers, privates and highwaymen essentially, so I don't think they have a centralized government, at least not in the strictest sense of the word. And I do believe wiping out the Orion privates or at least their base in the vicinity will be the next on the Klingon High Council's agenda, no doubt, which will be left to us of course, since we are in the feared at all, and at this point in time we have a little bit of experience under our belt. So without further ado, we kick off the next mission in the single player campaign, which is called Into the Arena. So that probably will feature quite a bit of combat if I had to guess.
The Taubat, as expected, have betrayed us and sided with the Federation. Yesterday they promised us worlds in return for military aid. Today, they refute our claims. The Tabula Rasa is ours by right, and you will secure it for the Empire.
All of it,
your
really?
Target is Mazikan, capital of the Taubat Planetary Commonwealth. Victory will cripple their government. Teach them the price of treachery, and bring all their worlds within our grasp.
I don't think we'll be the easy
Tal, the Taubat attacked without provocation. On Ixion, their lies spilled our warriors' blood. The final insult is Mazikan, where they deny our claims to court favor with the Federation. The Taubat believe siding with the Federation will afford them some protection. But the wheels of Federation politics move slowly. There can be no pact if the Mazikan Taubat do not live long enough to sign it.
That's all they
just
have to problem.
Destroy all Taubat on Mazikan. Destroy every building and every single craft. These dishonorable Nutcha have insulted the Empire. They will pay. Once again, the Taubat's primitive dilithium worship plays a pivotal role. Our rivals need that reactor intact to placate their potential bedfellows. We do not. Locate the Taubat Temple and destroy it before it can be occupied by Federation or Romulan forces. Our actions will anger the Federation and Romulans, but they will not risk all-out war for the sake of the Taubat.
It's
important that we do not provoke them unnecessarily. The High Council's rules of engagement are clear. Fire only in self-defense after a direct attack. Of course, precisely where one defensive action finishes and another incident begins is a matter only the local commander can judge. But remember, the enemy must fire first. Our colony here is new, but it is already home to a sizable army of Klingon warriors.
Oh, that's good.
One of your primary concerns will be the development of an infrastructure that can support, house, and arm them before they freeze in their tanks. The main Taubat settlement is highly vulnerable and relies on numbers rather than actual strength for defense. With such mineral resources at hand, you will soon be able to muster an army sufficiently powerful enough to overcome any number of these savages. The key to the Federation claim will be the size of the colony. To be considered a full outpost requires a staff of some 150 people. Only when the colony has reached this size, according to the Federation's own rules, can it apply for embassy status. Then, an ambassador will be dispatched immediately, but only if there are any Taubat left alive. Strike quickly! This time it will be warriors who snatch victory from the hands of the bureaucrats. Our former allies, the Romulans, also crave a diplomatic solution. They will try to seize the settlement and force the Taubat to side with them. Your task remains the same. Even Romulans cannot capture what has been destroyed. The battle should be swift and simple for a warrior of your skill. It is time the Taubat learn the true Klingon way. Bavang!
So it's a war of extermination, essentially, and time also seems to be of the essence. Well, maybe you can pull this off, but well, hopefully we have a couple of forces on the ground already, but if their defenses are kinda weak, maybe we can just build rush a couple of tanks and then see what's going on. And yeah, rules of engagement dictate that we are not to fire on the Romulans as well as the Federation vessels, as long as they don't fire on us first, which something we can set in the Allies menu, I believe. So off we go. And let's see what the situation looks like on the ground. Quite complicated, no doubt, right? So where are we with relation to everything else? So it's the sort of map edge again. Okay, we have a couple of tanks. And first things first, let's see. So Federation is on, yeah, yellow alert, please. And the same goes for the, I think it's the Romulan Empire. Yes, I recognize the Lumpoli logo. And of course, the other guys we just shoot on sight, essentially, all right. Hopefully this will do the trick, and I think we just park them in the colony here now and set them to, actually, get some facilities up and running first. It's only the most basic one. We have a couple of power generators, but no, defenses to speak of, really. Actually, maybe it's booked too soon. We have a one photon defense turret and one artillery piece, I think, so off we go. Set them to combat group number 2, and hopefully we also have a scout vehicle someplace, and there it is. The only the VCOM one, but we have to do for now, I'm afraid. So we set them over here as a blocking force. And this thing we will set on number 1, and then see what we can find nearby. We need some resources, of course, and that seems to be the map as expected. So find us some useful information, please. So anything else I think we need to... there we go. Upgrade the colony hub as soon as possible. Right, artillery pieces. Wow, well, time's of the essence, but that's not really much of a strike force. So maybe actually, okay, we have a couple of turrets. We don't have a weak guard yet, so maybe we can with dispatching them after we have discovered a couple of useful buildings. So, research, should get going as soon as possible. So we need the vehicle yard for this, actually construction yard. Probably on this side, well defended behind the turrets. As soon as that is up and running, we can set on a couple of mining outposts at the very least, because at the moment we don't have any incoming source of raw materials, unfortunately. So what else do we need? The science station. Power generators we already have, thankfully. And this little structure we can set back here someplace to be well protected, hopefully. But let's not outpace our... Yeah, that should be a good idea. So maybe we can put our science officer to the recon vessel for that matter. I think that should be doable, so you make yourself useful there, please. And one of our security officers can go in these tanks, I guess, so... Okay. I think the mining station should be coming online here momentarily, so anything else we can see next door. Because while we don't want to stumble into the Federation base blindly with our combat forces, that would not be very good. There we go. So I think that unlocks the next... there we go. So up to the mining base, please. Party. Impossible, it only leaves us to the north. Okay. We need to find that capital and see how strong the defenses are, because I cannot really rely on our intelligence services giving us good information here. Okay. Very vigilant of fields, but it's not water lithium, unfortunately. But we think we should set down a second mining outpost regardless. Also upgrade our facilities while we are nearby. So we can vessel hopefully won't get blown to bits quickly. So this, there we go. We stay claims to these mineral fields as soon as possible. Okay, back to the hub we go. We are briefing and see what we can find. We also need to upgrade this or start doing so. We can only do a couple of science things at a time, unfortunately. So vehicle yard is something we need, of course, at the earliest convenience. It's a very large building and it should go next to the turret probably. And then we can set down another power generator in this general area. Because we need those. Maybe we leave this for a advanced one later on. Okay, the first wing has been finished. I think we should be able to put the second one inside right away. Or attach it, I should say. Okay, let's see what we have on the minimap. So we have, not quite sure what that is. Also, Federation Scout, that's not good, but we are not to engage them, even though it would be quite nice in this case, of course. So anything else? Yeah, we don't have any scanner range of our ships, so we just leave them close. Maybe set them to protect. Alright. Also be of use right now, upgrading the processor, of course, that would be a good start.
Science station standing by. Construction yard ready.
Arsenal, I think, should go all the way in the back here, since we cannot build this on these concrete slabs for whatever reason. Sickbay, yeah, we need to increase the pop cap before complete. We run out of populace, of course. And we have the field operating position to get a couple of static defense, which is good, because at the moment we, yeah, maybe we can press our way into the, so there's another. I think we're outpacing us a little bit in Vigo department, but I think we get the resource collection up and running before anyone else does. Because these do not replenish, of course. But they should be, yeah, there we go. Okay, anything else? Only number one, please. Yeah, this guy. I don't think we can remove them from the formation, but I don't think we can once they've been assigned, which is a little unfortunate. Okay, let's just leave them here for now, and then I hopefully can direct that scope manually. And once we have eyes on the enemy, we will probably attack them in one formation, assuming the defense aren't as strong.
Science station standing by.
Possible. Okay, but there must be something over there, right? Oh, Science Station has been upgraded again. We also check our objectives debrief, of course, before we move on. So what's it all about? Capture the top of the temple. Okay, that's something we need. So, okay, time is of the essence, and we don't do anything except to wipe them off the map, essentially. And hopefully we can capture that temple finally, but we can only use APCs for this. Let's not forget. So is the vehicle line already? I think it is, and we need a couple of cargo bays. Three of those cargo are not
complete.
As important. These are, on the other hand, are.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, vehicle complete.
Vehicle
it's fantastic.
Complete.
This thing needs to be upgraded.
Vehicle complete.
And while we're here, we should also set down the colony house, I think
vehicle
it was.
Complete.
For another substantial increase in pop care, but
vehicle
that's another
complete.
Very large one, as you can see.
Vehicle complete.
Mine system ready.
The generator is apparently a required building to set down or at least unlock these other facilities. No, the defensive turrets.
Construction complete.
Okay, let's maybe put it here for now and actually just check the power situation. So,
vehicle yard ready.
Okay, it's not good. We are losing power.
Yeah,
we have to
complete.
Set down a couple of these right away before we have unlocked the more advanced building. I don't think adding wings will actually increase the power consumption of these buildings. If it does, it's not indicated anywhere, so let's see what it's all about. So, we have another source
by.
Of the lithium here, maybe. Okay, that's good. So, it's a rather expensive map, as you can see. For a change, I think it's the first time the game actually opens up a little bit. Then it also calls for a second recon vessel, so we have more information. Maybe even the science one. It's not as fast, but it's also a little more durable and has effective scanners. So there is a neutral unit. So it's a Romulan. Oh, so they're shooting outside. That's interesting. Also, it means the base must be nearby someplace. Yeah, but good to know. Good information.
Shield generator finished.
To generate a finish, hopefully we can build more turrets and then we can focus on building vehicles. But so if we have to wipe out the Romulans, they do have access to cloak tanks, right? Probably also some sizable base defenses. So, alright, there's another. It's a hostile unit, but it seems to be a Federation one. Maybe we'll see if they shoot on site. Alright, so. See, hopefully I can direct this so
there's... Vehicle complete.
Yeah, it's just the recon vessel, right? And, okay, where is the ready point of our vehicles?
Vehicle complete.
We'll have to cycle them again, I suppose.
Colonial house finished.
Yeah, colonial house finished, that's good. They're moving still, apparently, so there's the other guys. Maybe just set them to protection for now. Hopefully keep the base a little safer. Anything else we need? Power situation was not fantastic from what I remember. We should be unlocking the advanced power station relatively soon. Maybe it is already become available. But no, we have access. Okay, we can afford this in terms of power consumption right now, unfortunately. Okay, so this I'm not quite sure what we are missing. Advanced, yeah, so that would be why. And the construction yard. Search collector is fully upgraded, and I think we don't have a large stockpile of crates back at the mines, from what I can remember the values. Okay, so. Yeah, our vehicle vessel got blown up, didn't it? Or maybe not. Maybe it was someone else firing. As I've mentioned before, scavenging these bases and vehicles, they don't stay visible on the map, unfortunately, unless they're already in scanner veins. I'm quite sure what got blown up there, maybe was the quotation mark Costa Scout. Yeah, maybe we can zoom out a little bit and see. So, okay, that's a little better, but it's also even more sluggish. Okay, that's the Federation base, I would assume, at least somewhere in the vicinity. Okay, a couple more tanks so we can be aggressive. Maybe 5 would do for now. So they roll it off to White Home, but unfortunately, so it's only the Scout, really. Hmm. Maybe we should okay, I'm not quite sure. Yeah, we need to get some information first before we can react and make our proper decisions. So there's the unit, okay. There's a Romulan one, of course. Seems to be the Vicon Force. Then we are running into the top art already. Maybe the base is over here someplace. But the Vicon Vessel is pretty speedy and is quite adept at avoiding incoming fire, so hopefully it's something we can pull off with this thing because our science officer is inside. Alright, so I see some structures on the ground, so there is the... Alright, so there it is, finally, we have made ice on this person D, which means it should be the focus on our attack, and against the Romulans we are defensive, and against the Federation to the same extent. Okay. I think we hide at the mining base for now. To be good. Yeah, it's under attack, of course. So, is our... yeah, is it actually? Maybe we should just switch to the... Yeah, okay, they're firing on that thing. Makes sense. Let me move forward a little bit to one of our outposts and set our ships to protect, and hopefully this will be a sufficient blocking force, and we can also put some defensive turrets nearby, potentially. So this is... this is a Federation vessel. There's our... Just do scouting. I think we can. Well, you can give it a try. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, then we have to come up with something else. The disruptor. Okay, it is possible, thankfully. So maybe our construction beasts can get all the way out here. So we are shooting on sight on these Federation vessels already. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, the fire is making controlling this a little difficult right now, but maybe we can manage. Set out a couple more of our lovely, actually. Okay, we are already max out in terms of the pop cap, which is unfortunate, so it means we cannot build anything else right now. Then we have to maybe expand a couple of our ships here, or our lovely new hopper tanks, and also the second Vicon unit, which we should assign to this group once everything is in position. Focus fighting. Maybe our turrets don't make sense. Yeah, so they are really aggressive, apparently. Yeah, okay, I know. Could you please move here? Thank you. Good, yeah. Yeah, we've already outpaced our power generation, unfortunately. So get over here, please. But at least the turrets are still online. And yeah, so... Yeah, maybe it was not the smartest idea, outpacing our population cap again, so I don't think there's anything we can upgrade except to so that a couple of ships, or maybe spook to soon, so there's another 10 here, which is good. And that means we should, so there's tank. Alright, so the primary objective of course remains to wipe out the base, and we need to rely on steady defenses for the most part. Yeah, thank you, we are quite aware of that. Is it everyone? Yes. So formation number 3 for now. Then we get on the map and then sit him on the very way. Yeah, I think that was the Taubert attacking us. I'm not quite sure if we can punch through the defenses, but we can certainly... I know. I'm trying to build this as soon as possible. And there we go. Hopefully the advanced power plant has become available already, and that is fantastic. I need a couple of those at the very least, bare minimum, and also some shields and further defenses, and that's something we can do without upgrading the power plant, of course. very effective one. But still learning experience naturally. Maybe put it a little further in the back just to be on the safe side. Near our defenses back there. Okay, I don't think there's anything else we need to upgrade, except for specialist, yard. And there were crew tanks are good at all, but I don't think they're exactly a fantastic value for money. We need some APCs, but for worse things, we need actually punch through the defenses, right? Until we, I think we rely on these things because they're not as expensive. Yeah, 5 would do. Okay, well, that's not that good, of course. So then we are back in the pop cap, so we get over there, please. So, ready. Took a little bit of damage. I think we lost the one ship someplace, but I think outside defenses are doing a good job, at least as far as I can tell. And who's a straggler? So it's another disruptor tank. Right, I think these guys, they can just make an formation one, all of them, and then we move forward. This put a little bit of pressure on them. That's fantastic. Hopefully this will fix the power problem for the time being.
Vehicle complete.
And there we go. Consumption 58 out of 100. Cargo bees will be a little low on them apparently, but I would rather focus on the offensive walls for now. And once we lose a couple of ships, then we can go back. And actually, we lost all of our recon vessels. Is that not correct? That's actually the science vessel. Okay. Okay then, yeah, losing a little bit of overview because, yeah, this is very hectic. Okay, friendly unit, yeah, of course, they are a lot slower. Some of the other ships that is gone, scout not so much, so we can do a little more scouting and find a proper angle into the torpedo base. And I think we can leave our base behind for now and deal with the threats that they're incoming with our turrets. We set down a couple more, but I think it wasn't the general vicinity supported by the Federation as well as the the Romulan Star Empire. So it's another which field we should exploit right away while we can. We do have access to the advanced mine, or at least we should, yes. And it makes
warning.
It also
colony is under attack.
There we go, advanced mine. Doesn't matter if it does matter a little bit if it does get destroyed, but I think we can afford it. If it came to that. Photon defense, shield generator. Wow, there's no point of putting them out there. It's a rather disposable structure. I think there was one teil I briefly saw. There we
building
go.
Construction delayed.
Yeah, okay, then we have to be patient a little bit here. We also need to dispatch our other beacon, or at least the science vessel. Okay, another field.
Building. The side.
Yeah, who is attacking? Yeah, I know there. Come on, guys. Yeah, okay, the turrets are still operational, which is good. So we have a couple of vehicles nearby. We could, so these guys, they will set themselves to protection for now. This here. Still moving apparently. We cannot abort that order, unfortunately. Okay. These guys here all. Yeah. Big doofus, as I fully expected, because, wow. Yeah, get out of here, please.
Vehicle complete.
Don't suicide yourself against their defenses, thank you. Not before we are ready to make a move. Dude. I'm sure if we have the forces at hand to punch our way through these defenses. Yeah, okay. So we can maybe fix it right now instead of in the second. But we need eyes. I feel like close need to find that. Yeah, Kach over there, please. And then we sit down at the mining station before anyone else can start to extract these resources. But we need eyes on them, like personally. Or ships, as you can see. I think there was a flat tile over here someplace, and the advanced mining station is more heavily shielded than the regular one.
Yeah. Objective completed.
It sounded like a Federation voice. Lovely. Okay, I think we will lose this thing, unfortunately. At least that we can actually see them thanks to our.
Yeah,
there we go, try to intercept them, please. Apparently, that thing survived, but only barely. So, very hectic, can we please set down that binding station before I lose track here? Photon defense, well, that's good, but we cannot build it all the way out there, I believe. Oh, come on, it's the last building in the list, isn't it? Yeah, of course it is. Oh. There we go.
Building construction delay.
Whatever, so there was one objective. I think it was the Federation one, so since they are working against us, the same goes for the Romulans, but it makes sense. Yeah, I think we have to make a post-haste to destroy some of these buildings. Maybe at least there are mobile forces, and we also need some APCs, of course. Okay. Interesting that we can actually keep track of the other people when it comes to the objectives, right? I'm not quite sure if you can scan anything, so just keep close to the VCOM vessel and hopefully not get destroyed. I think our formation is a one big mess again, I can barely see of course from this screen, so we can... one ship at a time, the usual. And these cloaked vessels, they are very annoying of course, especially if they're used against you. Okay, do we have anything in the way of pop caps? Only one at the moment, which means we should probably queue up one APC, but we need more than one of those. But if the other defense are down, it doesn't matter as much, I believe. So there we go, arm transport. Yeah, hopefully we can deal with this and have some defensive positions prepared. Okay, we just see what we can find then, get a little closer. Compatible pave the way.
Vehicle complete.
So there we go. Blast these idiots, thank you. Let's suicide our vessels ideally. I think we rush these turrets. We can. From this side ideally. Yeah, I cannot complete their mission, which is good. Actually, they cannot. Get over there, please, come on, guys. Yeah, so much for them not having good defenses, right? Oh, did they just for all of what? What? You kidding me? We lost every single photon tank, every single one against two tiny turrets. Okay, well, then we just return to the ready point for now, I think, back home, and then we see what can make happen with the other ships we have to rebuild. So that's a lovely, nasty surprise. Yeah, absolutely lovely, and we also lost our V-compressor, of course. Oh, this is great. Okay. Well, so much for that. Yeah, easy peasy, and so on and so forth. So cannot, or should we not allow them to? That's what I want to know here. Okay, so, well, heavy reliance on these disruptor tanks, apparently not a good idea. So what's about our pop cap? We had way down, of course. Oh man, this is really not good. It really is not. Okay, not what I was expecting here, but I have absolutely no idea as to how powerful our vehicles are in relation to anything else at this point in time. Okay, we just try. Okay, we have three photon tanks, and then we are looking at a couple more phaser tanks because we really need those. They're quite essential. Yeah, fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. And we already have the next selection of idiots incoming. You have to be kidding me with this. Like, you saw that, right? Oh, we had like 10 disruptor tanks and they lasted about maybe 30 seconds in total against two turrets, which they can easily replace, you know, very easily. Okay, then we try to... I mean, I tried to do this in the first mission and the photon artillery had a lower range than the actual turrets, you know, of the enemy forces. Absolutely unbelievable. So these things take a long time to build, of course, yeah.
Vehicle complete.
Jesus Christ. Okay, get it online here, please. Thank you. Why is our landing point all the way over there for that matter? It's not very convenient, their game.
Science station standing by.
Okay, yeah, I know. Hopefully this is like a permanent mission fail on their side. Let's have destroyed really. We certainly did not. So that must have been someone else wiping out their base. We didn't even find in advance. So there's no... Okay. Can you make us a fuse for that, please?
Vehicle complete.
Can you where they're flying to for that matter? Must be one of our to the north here against the Torbard. So our photon artillery is incoming, whatever is left of them. Okay, unfortunately the buildings use the same pop cap as the vehicles, so we cannot set down too many defensive turrets, which helps us hope that these will serve the purpose for quite some time to come. And they seem to be relatively sturdy, at least against the Torbard vehicles. This is a Federation of Phaser tank. Man. Come on guys, build these vehicles already. No, we aren't really flush in resources right now. I don't think building multiple ones at the same time will offer any advantages. So what about an engineer of ours? It's an economy hub, so maybe move him into the vehicle yard to speed things up a little bit. That could work. There goes here. Okay, here is of course a science vessel got blown up by the VCOM vessel in particular, and the same event for our security officer in one of the tanks, so that's fantastic. Absolutely lovely. Okay, well, maybe we can do some scanning with our medical officer at the very least. So our returning from the valley point, which maybe in this case here, this little tiny sprite, which I can barely see on my monitor, this little beacon, I believe. So already then.
Gosh.
Go here for now, please. I think we can rely on the static defenses for now. Yeah, they don't acknowledge my order, so they won't go there. Pretty sure. Okay, in this case they can. Yeah, these guys can please also move there, if I can select them. Apparently it's not possible, but we have to do this from the other view, unfortunately. Okay then. Yeah, one is pretty damaged, as you can see. In the heavy conversion, we order back to the wedding point. Yeah, really, I'm not quite sure how we can punch our way through the defenses if the turrets are so sturdy and our vehicles are so squishy by comparison. Maybe I can try to put the photon artillery in a second formation and then try to bombard these while moving around, you know, leaving the tanks outside of their effective weapon range. But that's why we experimented with these things, right? So, the Federation is making substantial progress apparently, which is not good. So, what about the build queue? So, we have a couple more. Okay, maybe we can make them come with us later. They can play catch up. So, maybe this is the artillery, which is a lot slower than anything else. So, okay, I think we have one APC. It's also with the formation, which is not fantastic. And we need a recon vessel because ours got blown up again, I think. And we should be able to put a couple more. So, yeah, one beacon vessel, please, if you can queue it up, because I want to, stumble into these things blindly. And that's the advanced artillery, if you want to use it. Maybe try a one on, just for size, and see how well it goes. A beacon vessel, and I think we're already maxed out, and we want to have at least a one emergency, pop cap remaining. We need to set up a turret someplace, and these have survived thus far, which is interesting, but we need more cargo bees, apparently. Okay, so we can actually get the resources delivered to the processor.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, well, they can. Can you please move over there? We need your service. Thank you. Come on, guys. We want to accomplish things today still. And I don't think anything else has been completed yet. Not even the. Okay, capture the Talbot Temple. Hopefully, we cannot destroy it this time around. It calls for the services of a NPC. So I guess we mow down as many turrets as if possible with the VCON vessel providing advanced knowledge and warning, so I redirect this manually, and I think I set it to, it's 2-1, make it a little easier to coordinate. Okay. Yeah, thank you, I know, it's to be expected, but we cannot set down any more mining outposts at the moment. Maybe I scrap one of those, it has one drive. Oh wait, that's something we do actually, that seems to be a good plan in my book, so erase that thing here, please. And that should free up at least one stone for our pop cap here, yeah, there we go. I think that's the case. Otherwise it could have been a rather unfortunate mistake. Right, there we go, okay. Right in front of the faces and centrally, right? So where are we? Okay, it's obviously not the best. I think we direct this from the tricorder view actually. So there's one structure, and I think they had at least two turrets on this side someplace. Alright. Well, let's see, maybe we can find something. This is, okay, this side has been cleared in some fashion that we can hopefully move in there. Also, they're building more structures, which is interesting. Obviously, it's actually our mining outpost. Yeah, got a little spook there. Okay, so let's see about the other people. Forward, please. The VCON vessel will return to the safety of our main formation. But if the Romulans have been knocked out of way, that means they cannot dispatch any more crewed ships. So just some tower again, I'm not too worried about those. Wait about what's going on over here, if we can see the action. And of course, yeah, they also had artillery on their side, of course. Need to force that all naturally fine could also be here.
Warning! Colony is under attack!
Yeah, having this many ships, that makes it a door. Hard, of course, to coordinate, and we also want to dispatch our artillery pieces separately, if possible. Can you please stay outside of their effective range, at least their turrets? Yes, that would be good. No, 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 get back here, please. Come on, come on, come on, we don't need to waste all of these vehicles here. Oh, these artillery pieces are so goddamn slow, it's really annoying. Hopefully our base can fend for itself for the time being. Well, I'm trying to direct things manually. I don't believe we can just click here or select our artillery pieces separately. It's something we have to do on the battlefield. Ideally before the battle starts, not afterwards, so... Okay. So I can already find this also good. And a fine one for that matter. Now some Federation vessels apparently. Okay, we try to get over there, yes, separately, and our phaser tanks will provide close range protection here, hopefully. There we go. Oh, come on, guys, obey my orders, get in the proper formation, thank you. Yeah, that's the usual pathfinding issues of this game. Come on, I'm already done. I will set everyone to better alert if they aren't already, because our guys are apparently a little blind, even though the enemy is right next to them. Okay, so the artillery pieces are... No, they still aren't. Get over there. Thank you. Apparently doesn't want to, while then we just set... can we trick the... we cannot use control, unfortunately, for this purpose, so... Finally, now it can move. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry for the micromanagement, really is required, unfortunately. So, really, still nothing? Come on. It's really quite important, yes, thank you. Oh, man, you have to be kidding me with this. Okay, there's the APC, it should go on its own. Yeah, control 4 probably. There we go, finally. Finally something working in our favor. And these guys, they will be set to, And come on, it can't be so hard, you know. So baby orders here, get out of the stupid way here. Yes, thank you. So these guys will go on squad number 2. And then we will set the phaser tanks to squad number 1. And hopefully this will ensure that I can... coordinate all of these guys at the same time without running into these turrets here by accident. Okay, I think the remaining turret was over here someplace, so we move forward with our artillery pieces carefully. They try to find the piece and eliminate this, and they can also dodge fire with these, thankfully. So maybe they don't back out again and be big doofuses. I think it was over here someplace. I'm not sure if this is the ideal angle to attack this base from, but we'll find out soon enough, won't we? Okay, a little closer, please. Yeah, really disappointed our phaser tanks are so squishy. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Get a little closer. There we go. We find the FI. Oh, sorry, of course, they have rebuilt that thing already, as you would think. We find a couple of. Yeah, so that's the first piece they're going already. It's great. Man, why are all of our vehicles so squishy? We cannot really form a 50 ships or something that is impossible, unfortunately. And we cannot waste in there to suicide. I mean, come on, what the heck is this? I'm really at a loss here, to be honest. These vehicles, they shouldn't be quite so squishy. Okay, then we just get in here with all of our... No, get in here with all our people, and then we try to rush this one turret and destroy it before we lose all of our vessels here. Move! Move your asses, please! Come on, shoot, get over there. Don't be so hard, yes. So that would be why they're refusing to get over there, that means the turrets can pick off these Yeah, I can pick off these tanks here one ship at a time. That's the usual problems with the formation, right? Okay, maybe we can take down these. Are we making some progress finally? But we're losing all of our vessels here in the process, as you think. What are we shooting that over there? Not quite sure. Hopefully that will power them down, but I don't, to be honest. Okay, we'll make ourselves useful and see what the damage looks like. It seems to be very close to catastrophic, and they can of course... yeah, we don't have any advantage whatsoever, so we need to be able to just build rush these things here, as many as possible, I guess. Of course, there's another vehicle gone, because well, we are stupid. But over there, keep moving, don't stand here like we doofuses. Especially not against artillery pieces, you idiots. Okay, that's just not working. We have to return to the rallying point before we get blown to bits. And by the time we return, they will have rebuilt all those turrets, which I can guarantee you. But only four heavily damaged, making three heavily damaged tanks, and we cannot accomplish anything whatsoever. Yeah, lovely job, guys. Once again, fantastic. Yeah, why are the turrets so effective and our vehicles are so useless by comparison? I do not understand. So can we accomplish anything else? Yeah, the recon vessel has been blown to bits already, and let's see. So, okay, maybe set down a second vehicle yard. Hopefully this will speed up things and allow us to build multiple production lines at the same time. Can we give it a spin? I haven't tried this before. We'll see how well it goes. Yeah, fantastic. I don't think anyone survived. Yeah, didn't. So, yeah, feed heavily damaged tanks. And you saw what force we brought to the table, but it was not sufficient, apparently. Like, no fashion whatsoever. Yeah, insufficient crew, really. Yeah, so, oh, really, that's another thing that we have to worry about in this title, apparently. So, wow, really, I'm not quite sure. We cannot build anything else. Realistically speaking, can we do? I mean, once again, the tutorial didn't actually, so we are completely out of crew, really? Complete. Yeah. Well, we have two officers, zero crew, and 120 available in the pool, and then we have the teleporter pad, so I'm not quite sure, what's the issue then? Maybe we just have to wait for our reinforcements to arrive over time. But yeah, oh, man. I'm really completely at a loss here, folks. I really am. So we have a couple of vehicles at the very least. So we just retreat to the safety of this here and then see what we can find, because there are a couple of turrets nearby. And then we have to rebuild our formation from scratch. Yeah, so suiciding our vehicles is not a possibility either, as we can see.
Vehicle complete.
Yeah, so we're running out of minerals again. Is that not also a concern? Actually, it looks relatively decent. Yeah, how do we get past these defenses if the artillery pieces are always outside of range? And if our vehicles form a one after another formation type of thing, you know, that makes them very easy pickings for the enemy. And also static defenses, and once again, by the time we get back there, they will have replenished all of this, yeah, without question. Okay, so we have to upgrade this building so pretty as far as it would seem. Okay, makes sense. Our ships are so slow. Takes ages to get anywhere. Especially forming up the not so effective formation. Oh, come on, guys, get over there. We need to be on the offensive. Time is of the essence, don't you know? Okay, they're still set to 4, I believe, which is good. This will be peace. Well, this is the advanced form, which will be completely again blown to bits here immediately as soon as we close in range of the first tower that has been built already. I will have a little bird, you know, so it's a matter of not seeing it at the moment. And yeah, so pathfinding in this game seems to be a massive concern, and it really makes it quite frustrating to move ahead against these defenses. So I think the turbo's over here someplace. So we just try to rush it and blast it as the earliest convenience together with our artillery piece, our new one. And hopefully this will be good enough, because while the full artillery takes ages to get over here. Oh man. Yeah, look at this. This seems to be their wedding point for that matter. So there we go. Yeah, of course, we have paced forward and got immediately blasted to pieces. Lovely, yeah, just lovely. So it only takes like two shots at most to destroy one of our disruptor tanks. So what's the next stage then? I don't think the cloak tanks will be very sturdy, or not sturdy, or maybe not even sturdy, like whatsoever. It can be Blasted finger, please. Get me in range, yes. Two swords, it's down. I don't think we can dodge any incoming fire, I believe. Over there. Look at the damage we're taking. It's outlandish. It really is outlandish. Destroy these turrets, please. Jesus Christ. I don't think it is will accomplish anything because we don't even know what this structure is good for. Ah, then can we take it over necessarily? Okay, well, at least it. I mean, look at the situation right now. We only had a couple of opponents here. Video was only some static turrets, and then still we lost half of forces here right away. Constantly we're building these tanks, so it doesn't do anything like whatsoever, so we just leave them over there and hope they don't get blasted to bits here immediately. Federation scout there is a charge against our defenses, I'm alright with that. I guess we just race past all of these structures and they will open fire and roll automatically, hopefully against the turret. Maybe that's a strategy that could be working for us. Should focus fire on the most important targets first, I hope. Now, are you quite sure? Because the store of a couple of the tourists making lives for us miserable, in case you haven't noticed. But the Federation cannot complete its mission either, which is good, which was a diplomatic assistance and also a military one. Yeah, speaking of which. Get over here, blow up these turrets, thank you. Oh, are they really having a traffic jam against the artillery? Really? Very annoying. Extremely annoying. So we have to wipe out their defenses, their assistance here first, because this seems to be one of the better vehicles on their side. So instead we just use the move feature at all times, except attack manually, which seems to freeze us in position. Yeah, actually makes our vehicles sitting guns more or less. So the artillery should be defenseless and includes RDS. And destroy this thing already, thank you. Okay, so where is the tempo of theirs? Not quite sure. Of course it's not on scanners. Oh, this is a couple of friends dealt with finally. Okay, see more friends on the minimap already. Over here, make this useful, thank you. Okay, apparently the tempo has been destroyed, or it's not in the space, which is good. But we still need to capture this structure, of course. maybe we will deal with the Federation then after all, because they're kinda making life force visible. And yeah, can you get over there, please? So, the capital has been destroyed, finally. Which means we can consolidate our position, and then wow, these vehicles are pretty beat up, so we just then pull back for a little bit here and deal with these Federation idiots. That would be swell if we could. Okay, let's see about our objectives then. Yeah, capture the Turbo Tempo. We are not quite sure where it is, which is interesting, so we need to invest some energy and resources in building a couple more weak vessels because they get blown to bits at all times here. Okay, maybe two will do for now since we lost so many vessels anyway. Okay, this little Krafafo, have we wiped out the Federation Vehicle force, complete. Yes?
Vehicle complete.
It's not looking too hot as you can see, but maybe we can pull back for now and have them stationed at the, together with the other friendly forces. And hopefully this thing also survive, we need it later. So we're parking nearby for better protection. And let's see what's back at the base. Also wanted to, yeah, we don't, well, let's not get too cocky. I think we set down one defensive turret here just in case. And there we go, static defenses on this side, please. It was a blind spot of ours, apparently. So there is one beacon vessel, and there's another one. So hopefully we can send them on their merry way and find ourselves that tempo we have to discover and also capture in some fashion. And where would that be? I think the Romulan base got completely wiped out by the Federation, probably. So I don't think there's anything left on this side. But granted, we have not done a thorough reconnaissance of the entire area. And that means our other recon vessel will probably get over here someplace, if we can. Well, folks, I'm not sure what to tell you, but I sent my VCOM vessels across the map multiple times over, and the only thing we keep encountering are these relentless reinforcement waves coming in from the north, and I do believe it's something the game spawns in from off-screen as opposed to something the enemy AI is building in their base, which, neither of these exist anymore, of course, and I think the Federation structures were supposed to be just in the vicinity, and the Romulan one over here, respectively, and since we did not see a temple looking facility in the capital city, I'm not quite sure if the inability to satisfy the secondary objective and thus also complete the mission was actually down to my my monkey brain as usual or something else breaking. Maybe the mission designer not talking to the writer, for instance, which is something I have noticed, you know, in the other missions as well. There seems to be a distinct gap sometimes between what you are supposed to do in the intro video as opposed to what's actually playing out throughout the mission. And about there's nothing else here really, to be honest, and I'm rather tired of wasting my time or replaying the mission for that matter, so I guess we just declare victory, which is something we have certainly achieved for the Klingon Empire, and move on with the next mission. But I'm intrigued to see what the game has in store for us next, because the Romulans as well as the Federation have been added to the mix now, and it means things should get a lot more heated and a lot more interesting and probably also a lot more hectic, which hopefully won't overwhelm my slowest monkey pain again. But yeah, I'm sure, to be honest, that maybe I can review the footage, but I'm pretty certain I did not see a temple looking structure, only these turrets we blasted or got blasted by, depending on which reinforcement wave we dispatched their way, and otherwise we only saw these generic looking structures, which we unfortunately did not get to scan because our VCOM vessels got blown up in quick succession. But if there's one thing to take away from this mission, that is the fact that the game has apparently become a little more stable thanks to the recent changes I made in DXWnd and has not crashed throughout the entire thing, even though it has been running for 1.5 hours in Vietnam, I believe, or at least close to it. But yeah, I think that's all we can accomplish here, unfortunately. So nothing else to say except to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.